Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today I will be talking about the coronavirus just a little bit as a transition because I simply cannot upload without acknowledging what's going on in the world. I was a little bit ill in the past week as well. That's why you didn't have the video on Wednesday. I do apologize. I'm no medical professional, so don't take every single thing I say as a fact. This is just my opinion on the matter, and if you would like to find out how I am recreating my recreation from 2 weeks ago, then just keep on watching. Very original, I know. So before I actually get started, I do have to say that the first initial portion of this video is going to be a voiceover because I have builders changing the roof. They taken down the roof and put a new one back on. There was loads of loud noise in the background and I thought it's gonna annoy me that something is interrupting me. So the first portion of this video is a voiceover. I hope you don't mind. This is the same makeup look I did with my sister. However, I had my own go at it. Mine is fully matte. I love wearing matte shades on my eyes. I'm rambling. Let's get into the video. Okay, let's get started. I've never done a voiceover over a makeup tutorial, so bear with me. Today, as you would have seen in the intro, I'm recreating the Nikki Tutorials makeup look I did with my sister. I started off by moisturizing my face with the Revolution SPF moisturizer. I'm testing it out for you guys, and I will have a video on that soon. Speaking of videos, I also want to do a declutter video, so let me know if you would love to see that. My stash isn't the biggest. I think it would still be interesting to watch though. Anyway, let's get started. I'm priming my lids with the Morphe concealer. I'm priming half of my lid because I will be cutting my crease. Now I'm going to take a fluffy brush and the Neon Green Obsessions from Huda Beauty. I'm taking the Citrouille shade. This is my favorite shade. It is so good. I'm going to stamp it in my crease. It'll help us with blending later on. But as you can see, I'm taking the shade quite far up. It's amazing. I then want to build some more color, so I'm taking another brush and the Alexis Stone palette with Revolution. I'm going to use the green row, as you can imagine, and I'm taking the third green down. I want to build the intensity of the green. I want to add depth, so I'm putting that green in the crease also, in with the Citrouille shade, and slowly build my gradient. I'm also going to take my previous brush that I used for the Citrouille and go over the edges with that brush as well. I then want to deepen the crease even further, and for that I'm going back to the Alexis Stone palette. I am taking the last green and I'm even dipping into the black just a little bit. And like I said, I'm putting that in the crease, I'm building the intensity. This shade is actually going to somewhat disappear because, as you can see, this is quite low down in my crease. This is only a hue of color in the final product, but it is very, very important to add that depth. Okay, time to cut the crease. However, before I do that, I do like to clean up that area to get a very nice crisp line. To do that, all you need is a Q-tip and a little bit of makeup remover. Then I'm taking a flat brush, a little bit more of my Morphe concealer, and I'm putting that concealer in the negative space on my lid to create a cut crease. And you could easily just set your lid with that shimmery Citrouille colour. It's beautiful. However, I want my look to be fully matte, so I'm taking the matte Citrouille shade and I'm setting the middle of my lid. For the inner portion of my lid, I want it to be a little bit lighter, so I'm taking the milky green is what my sister called it, and I'm putting that on the inner third. For the outer corner, I'm going to start with the lighter green, which is the third shade down in the Alexis Stone palette. However, I do want to intensify the very, very edge, so I'm taking the same concoction that I have on my upper lid, which is the last green shade and a little bit of black, and I'm putting that on the very edge of my eye. I'm blending everything in, and then there's one more cleanup that we need to do, and it is on the outer corner. I'm taking a cotton round and a little bit of makeup remover, and I wipe the outer corner to create a nice sharp wing. Since last time, I bought the Drug Lord liquid lipstick from Jeffree Star because I did miss a white liquid liner in my collection. This is perfect. So I'm going to use that for my liner. Whew! That was a mission and a half. Time to take a quality liquid lipstick, and I'm going to take an angled brush and begin to give myself a wing. I want this to be ombre or gradient, call it whatever you want, but I want a darker wing starting from the inner portion, and then on the outer corner I'm going to use No Offense from Jeffree Star, which is like a citrus liquid lipstick, and that's going to be my wing. I highly recommend giving these liners two layers, so you need to take a little break and give them another layer, and then you'll achieve a really nice, true, sharp liner. I really like this. I'm going to do the other eye off camera and I will be right back. Okay, so the builders have gone for some kind of break, I think. However, I do want to talk about the situation that is happening in the world, and I think it'll be better if I can do it directly rather than with a voiceover. But in the meantime, as I'm talking to you guys, I'm going to put my foundation on because I finished my eyes for now. I'm taking the Maybelline Superstay. It's pretty much empty now. I'm just trying to finish these two shades that I have, the light beige and ivory. I'm still on hunt for the right shade for me because it's probably somewhat in between those two shades. So the coronavirus, the current pandemic virus, it's very, very scary that such a disease can spread so quickly, and it kind of gives you an insight on how those types of things that you usually just read in history books, you know, like the plague wiped out thousands and millions of people, you only read that in books, and right now people are realizing, oh wait, this is actually real. There's two types of people, I feel like. There's no happy medium. Type A person is not taking it seriously. He's going to bars, he sneezes into his hand, doesn't care about washing it after, you know, coughs like this and spreads all the germs everywhere, and that's type A. Type B is a complete opposite. The type B's bought out all the toilet paper, the rice, the pasta at Tesco's, and doesn't really care about anybody else. They are equally as bad in the sense that they are only thinking about themselves. All of my condolences to the people that have died since the outbreak. It's heartbreaking that it's spreading so quickly. However, we do have to remain sane. Just be reasonable. Wash your hands. Don't cough into people's faces. The worst thing you can do is touch your face, obviously. If you guys don't know, the virus enters through your mouth, through your nose, or through your eyes. It kind of freaks me out to think about how it enters through the eyes, but it does. I don't think it enters through your ears. There's no actual hole in your ear. Correct me if I'm wrong. Again, guys, I'm not a scientist, I'm not a medical professional. However, I do have some kind of medical knowledge and, like, just sanity, you know? An example of how I feel like I'm being quite reasonable. I was ill just this past week. I went to see my best friend. got the train, then I got the metro. I went out, I only wore a dress. I don't wear jackets on a night out. And it wasn't that warm. Got home after that weekend, and then on like a Tuesday, I started getting like a really clogged nose. It feels like water in your sinuses. You get a tissue, you blow your nose, and it fills right back up. That's what I had on like Tuesday, Wednesday. And then on a Wednesday, because I had stuffed nose, I couldn't breathe during the night through my nose, so I slept like this. And because you sleep with your mouth open, it dried out my throat and I started coughing. I was like, you know what? This isn't coronavirus. I could panic and, you know, ring 111, but I'm gonna be reasonable about it. I don't have temperature. My temperature was 36.2 Celsius, which is your average body temperature. Didn't feel achy. It wasn't like flu symptoms. I only had a stuffed nose and I had a cough. Be sensible. In my head, there's always those thoughts, anxious thoughts, that kind of spiral into anxious body. It just happens. It's our nature. The reason why I did check my temperature was because I wanted to know whether I don't have the coronavirus or not. I was worried that I do, because I was on the train from London to Edinburgh. But again, I was reasonable, and I encourage you all to be reasonable. You know your body, and if something doesn't feel right, it's always better to check. In England, we can ring, like I said, I believe it's 111. Someone will pick up and you'll get some advice on what you can do. They will essentially check if you have the symptoms of the coronavirus. Stay at home, ask your relative to get you some medicine, get some tablets for any potential cough that you have. Again, you know your body best. If your cough is very severe, if you're coughing up blood, that's never good. And obviously you can't self-isolate when you're coughing up blood. You need medical help when that happens. Loads of medicine in supermarkets, treat yourself, that kind of thing. The reason why I said ask a relative or ask a friend or something is because if you do feel unwell, it's unwise to walk around and spread germs, whether it is a coronavirus or not. So be wise and think about what you're doing. The people that are at the most risk are elderly and people with like an immune deficiency. The coronavirus can take up to like 5 days, I believe, to even show symptoms of you having it. So you can be carrying coronavirus and you can spread coronavirus without knowing that you have it. In fact, you can have the coronavirus and have no symptoms whatsoever. I read an article where it was found that some kids carrying the coronavirus without any symptoms at all. That is very scary to think about. So just be careful, guys. Be reasonable, be careful. This is very serious, but don't panic. If you're a young child, a teenager, a young person, like mature, up to the age of like 60, if you are healthy on a daily basis, you will be fine. Even if you do get the coronavirus, you will be fine. Your body can fight it. Your body is healthy enough to have a natural way of fighting off diseases. If you are struggling to breathe, ring 111 or 999 if you're in the UK, and you will get some medical advice and help to help you fight this off. I just realized I've got loads of concealer on my dress. Great. Let's get back into the video because I've rambled enough. For my bronzer, nothing new, Revolution Matte Base Concealer in 13.5. For my under eye concealer, I'm gonna use Collection Lasting Perfection in number 1 Fair. I have to put blush on, I can't live without it. So today I'm gonna use the Revolution Patricia Bright Face Palette. This is the Moonlight Glow for Fair Skins. For my highlight today, because I wanna go low, I'm going to take the Jaclyn Cosmetics Loose Highlighter. Oh, an extra. And I need it in several places. I'm taking a small flat brush to firstly highlight my inner corner. I need it under my brow bone, under my brow bone, under my brow, on my brow bone. I also like to use smaller brushes recently on my nose and the bridge. And of course, I'm gonna highlight my face. I have to do my brows because I cannot look at myself. I'm of course going to fill them in with the Eyelow Pomade in Blonde. And now it's time to get back into the eyes. I shall start with a somewhat flat brush, and I'm going to take that green from the Alexis Stone palette, the third one down, and I'm going to stamp it on my lower lash line. And then to buff out the edges, I'm going to take that Citrus shade from the Huda Beauty. I love this shade. Just in case I haven't told you before, I love this shade. I recently bought the Bambi Eye False Lash Mascara from L'Oreal. It's very lengthening, but I definitely prefer the Lash Paradise or Lash Ecstatic. It just makes my lashes a little bit thicker at the same time. This one is nice, again, it's nice. Nothing against it, but it just makes them long rather than like long and thick. Okay, and for my lips, I'm not gonna go crazy. In fact, I just wanna go quite natural. So I'm just gonna take Lip Maximizer from Dior. Use whatever you want. It doesn't have to be like this expensive. I won this in a giveaway. I just want my lips to be shiny, that's all. Okay you guys, so here it is. This is my final look. Yes, I did technically recreate the recreation I did like the other week, but I really wanted to give this makeup look another try, my go, my interpretation of it. I love the color scheme. I loved it then, and I personally prefer the matte over the shimmer. Like, this is fully matte and I'm dying. I hope you have enjoyed this video, even though it was kind of all over the place. I hope you stay safe. I hope you're going to be fine. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed that. If you did, make sure to like, comment, subscribe. I will be turning this into more of a St. Patrick's Day look, so make sure to check it out on my Instagram. But for now, thank you so much for watching. You are the best. I hope to see you next time.